So again, Matreprint for automating and standardizing the output workflows you have, or you might have. And that's one of our main targets, to help you support with your workflows. And if you think of such a workflow, you have your InDesign file, then you have someone sitting there doing tasks for the output. InDesign is outputting then manually. You create your PDF, then you have your PDF workflow, and at the end you have your PDF and your JPEG and any other output format. And a lot of customers, they buy Matreprint for their automation, but what they actually do is they only automate one part. So they automate the actual export and don't think about any other thing they can do with Matreprint. And I mean, it's fine for us. They bought the software, but they can even do more. They can pre-process the InDesign file and can automate this task. But where we actually want to go to is having them, like, they have their InDesign file, they put it into Matreprint, and at the end they have everything they need. Like, they have the finalized PDF, they have the finalized JPEG and finalized packages, or yeah, anything that goes. And Matreprint only for InDesign? No, of course not. So our main product line is for InDesign and InDesign Server. Current version is 2.7.3.1.5. It's available for CS6 to CC 2019. But we also have versions for Illustrator, like for Illustrator CS6 to CC 2018, version 0.3.7. And also we still have versions for Quark, up to Quark Express 2019. So we have a version for Illustrator, we have a version for InDesign and Express. We don't have a version for Photoshop, but you still can process Photoshop files in Matreprint InDesign. I don't know if you know that, but I'm going to switch to my InDesign. Let's only apply for the auto mode and server modes. And what I will do is I have an in folder where I place Photoshop file. Let's just have the sick Photoshop file. Place it in the in folder, and in Matreprint I can I tested a lot with David files. I have a lot of pingings in the when processing hot folders. You can say that you want embed external content, Photoshop files, Illustrator files, and images. We have that a couple of years now, but I think it's very unknown. So if I start the auto mode, it will process the Photoshop file just like it would process an InDesign file. In theory. Maybe I did the wrong folder. Okay, you can just open the folder and you see I don't have any files in there because I put it into the wrong folder. Huh. So if I put it here and start my auto mode, what we actually will do is we open the Photoshop file, placing it on an InDesign file, and then export the InDesign file. And that way we are able to process Photoshop files in InDesign. And that's so if you're ever looking for a Matreprint for Photoshop, use InDesign. Okay. So now to some features that are available since some time, but might be not often used. One is the parameter overrides, which you might know. InDesign is Matoprint is exporting using the InDesign export and using the InDesign PDF export presets. And with the parameter overrides, you can override specific settings in this export presets. And you can do that in the Matoprint job, but you can also override on the fly, asking the user which values he needs, or using job ticket modes or switch, you can also input metadata from the workflow. And this is one new thing. We also support the token engine in the value fields. So you can now ask the user individually, or you can access metadata, or you can place a text file with information somewhere in your system. And additionally, we also support the JPEG export now. So also in JPEG export, you can do the parameter overrides. Scripting. So Matoprint supports InDesign extend scripts. So if you have your InDesign scripts you do for checking, for enhancing the document, for standardizing the document. So for example, we had one customer who renames all the links to a specific file name. So after that, he packages the document and all the links have a specific name. Right. And with the scripting, you cannot do that stuff, but you can also tell Matoprint the outcome of the script. So if you have an scripting functionality, you have a function and you have something that goes wrong. For example, images are not placed on a specific file server or are not linked to a specific file server, but you want to do that and you can return an error. So if you return a string that begins with error, the document will stop processing in Matoprint. And everything after the first error will also be the error message in Matoprint. So if you work with switch, you can also put that error message back to the workflow, or K4 or Woodwing will just process that document or will process the error message to the user. Token engine, most of you are using the token engine, I'm pretty sure. It's a powerful string building functionality for example, for the file naming, but also for every part of Matoprint where you want to process a string. So for the parameter overrides, for example, for variables for the PDF toolbox, and file naming, of course. It can process strings, numbers, and functions. And it can access text files on the file system. And it even have if-else calculations, replacing text. You can display dialogues. And that's... So everything between those brackets is a token. So the token starts with an opening bracket and ends with an closing bracket. And everything in there can be a string, a number, a function, or an operator. So one of the operators you might already use is like the AND operator, which adds two strings or numbers. So if you start a token, you have a string made and a string to and a string print, it will outcome as made to print. What you often use, I think, is the combination with a function called page label, which will return the label of the currently printed page. And as you see, that can also be mixed with functions and strings and And just recently, we introduced the modulo operator, which will return the remainder of a division. So if you divide 2 by 2, there's no rest, so no remainder. And if you divide 5 by 3, you can divide it once, and you have a remainder of 2. So it's like the rest of an operation which can't be processed. And that can, for example, be used for file naming, where you you add the modulo operator to the page label, which will, for two page documents, always return 1 or 0. You can then put that into the if token, and one customer used that to add a right or left label to the file naming. So, control. I'm just at a page here. So I have a 4 pages document, and in mid-print I just use that token in the file naming. And you see I can add multiple tokens to one position. So for the destination file name, I had the document name is also just a simple token, which adds a document name function. Then I have my page label, and at the end, I add a right or left page. So if I execute that and go to my results folder, I have too many folders. And you can see I have only one page here, but it does contain the right label. I think it does not print because the other pages are empty. So if I just add a page box, and if I want it now, I still have one. You might need to trust me. Of course, because I have no single page. So I outputted the InDesign file to one PDF, and of course it does only have one file name. So if I do the single page output, which also is a nice feature in MatoPrint, I will have multiple pages. Yeah. And now I have my 4 PDF files. Right page, left page, right page, left page. So if you have a further workflow depending on those file naming, that's one option to do. Okay. Okay, so that was some explanation for the pre-process, so before the export. And then of course, MatoPrint can also post-process the PDF which was just generated in InDesign. That's all because we are very good partners with Color Software, have the PDF Toolbox engine integrated, and therefore you can run any PDF Toolbox profile you export from PDF Toolbox or from Acrobat Preflight, and you can just run that in the InDesign export process. And you don't need an additional PDF Toolbox, so for smaller companies, that's also like a good selling point. And also we support PDF Toolbox variables. So if you go to So in the made to print job, you have the option to PDF post process the exported file. And if you, I have a list of PDF toolbox profiles we deliver, and you can of course add your own ones. So you just click on manage profiles, it will open a folder with all KFPX files, and they should be just working. And here, for example, I have a job which is called place job ID in gutter, and that contains a variable in the toolbox profile to define the job ID. If I click on variables here, it will also, if you haven't set up, it will list all the variables that are in the profile. So you don't need to guess or whatever, it will just list list the fields. And for example here, we are now also able to process made to print tokens. And one of the token is the ask token, so you can ask the user on the when he exports the job. So if I export the job, it will ask me the job ID. I don't know, just call it Riga. And it exports to PDF. And you now see I have, in my PDF, I have the job ID down here. And I also have a barcode placed with the information Riga in it. So if you have your workflow, you have a scan, a barcode scanner somewhere, you just know which ID it is. That's a very simple one. As I said, you can run every PDF Toolbox profile you have. And the post process is also, sometimes you may have run across those, the PDF export command returned error, or export PDF can't process command error messages. That's mostly because you export or try to export an InDesign file which does not comply with an PDFX standard. In the if you export it manually, you get like a warning message. This file does not comply. Do you want to export it anyway? The problem for us is the SDK does not support that. The SDK just say no. But what you can do, you can export a plain simple PDF without, with no standard compliance in InDesign. So InDesign exports some kind of PDF. And then with the PDF post process, you convert it into your standard you want, like PDFX or PDFA. And InDesign does not support PDFA, but you can with Made to Print then convert the PDF to PDFA. So you get decent file out of InDesign. And also that works great with the parameter overrides, because if you have your PDF export preset and that defines the compliance, where is it? So if you set up the, for example, PDFX4 2008 in your profile, then you would still get this message. But you can override with the parameter overrides. You can say for PDF export, where was it? We should include a search here. Somewhere. Oh yeah, right. So you can just say standard compliance should be none. And then the error message is gone, and it will export, it will convert afterwards with the PDF Toolbox profile. The next one is configurations, and I would encourage, I would like you to, if you have support files, to send me configurations, because that does contain anything you I will need, and so it's good for sharing sets, and so print jobs, auto jobs, PDF export presets, profiles, scripts. So you export that on your machine or on the customer's machine, and on the other machine you can just import that and everything is there. And we have that like 5 years, 4 years, and I still get simple print jobs. I got so in support, if I have a support case, they, you send me print jobs, you send me afterwards some, later on you send me, I don't know, whatever we need. So just export the configuration and I have everything I need. And also for you, you can better distinguish between customers or clients, and the customer can better distinguish between publications, for example. It kind of works like the PDF toolbox profiles, libraries. So it's the same idea behind that. And we also do have that for the InDesign server. So if you have your jobs ready in InDesign, you have a whole configuration, you export that configuration to a MakeToPrint config file, you move that over to the to your server, and then you can use the MakeToPrint server UI to import that to the server. And the server also have all that you need. So all PDF export preferences, toolbox profiles, and so on. And in the latest version of the configuration, we also have the ability to delete and edit the configurations on the server. So there, before you needed to, you were able to import all the configurations, and then you have configuration, configuration one, configuration two, because you, you haven't been able to delete, but now you can also delete that, yeah. Okay, some further enhancements on the general processing. You may know if you put a folder into MakeToPrint with multiple InDesign files, we automatically create a book file and process all InDesign files to one PDF. And before we used some cryptic name for the book file, it was a little bit harder to get a nice PDF name out of it. And now we just use the folder name for the name of the book, and then with the book doc name token, you can have a good PDF at the end. Yeah. Books is a nice feature, and we struggle, right? Yeah. We're still not, we still have, yeah. some enhancements to the edit mode. I go to the InDesign. So what you may not have noticed on the plugins menu, we also have a MakeToPrint print jobs menu, and there we have a define option. And the define options directly goes to the edit mode. And you can you can also define your InDesign keyboard shortcuts to that. So if you're working a lot with MakeToPrint, you can just hit a keyboard shortcut and the edit mode of MakeToPrint will open. So it's like two clicks less, but it's just more convenient. And the same applies for the print jobs. You can the first 10 print jobs in the MakeToPrint list are listed in the menu and you can have keyboard shortcuts to them. And if you click on the keyboard shortcut, the profile or the print job will execute and create your PDF. So it's a nice way to speed up your work. And I mentioned that in the parameter overrides that we need a search, and we actually have a search in the print job list, and it's great to just filter the jobs. And what it actually does is it's a plain text search on the whole print job. So it's a text representation of the print job, and each print job that contains made-to-print space will now be listed, so the others are gone. If I go back, I have some more. And they can be used in various cases. So what you can do is you can search for parts of the destination folder. So if you know you change your file server address, you just type in the old one, and then you have a list of all jobs that output to that file server, and you can go through all made-to-print jobs and see what you need to change. Or if you use specific PDF presets that you want to change, you just use that the name of the PDF preset, and it will list you all jobs that uses that PDF preset, and then you can just change it where you need. And if you have a long list of of print jobs, that's really convenient to work with. I just wanted to mention that because I see even the oldest integration partners didn't know that, and that can really speed up your work. Right. That's we also have some minor enhancements in the edit dialog. So if you rename jobs or if you delete jobs, the cursor position is more where you expect it. So previously, if you deleted a job, the cursor jumped back to the first job, but now it's stayed where it is. And also, if you rename and close, you are on the job you just edited, and then it's, yeah. I mentioned that. So for the print jobs in the menu list, they are ordered just like they are ordered in the made-to-print menu. And if you have more than 10, you need to define which ones you want to have there. And then you can just use the rating or the priority of the jobs to push them up. And then you can use your keyboard shortcuts. We also enhanced our job ticket mode. Because we now support relative passes in the job ticket. That means you don't need to mention the whole pass to the InDesign document, but you just can say it's next to the XML, or it's in another folder, but it's related to that XML. So if you move the package of XML and InDesign file and placed objects, and you can just spread that out to different servers, and you don't need to adapt the passes. And it's just for easier administration of your workflows. And it applies for each and every section where you define a pass. So it's for the document, for scripts you have, or even for the output pass. So you can say, I want the PDFs next to the XML file, but in a subfolder. And
you mentioned this would be done in Swift.
Yes, I'm just on the way. if you use the job ticket mode, there are two things you need to know if you, or one thing, if the document you process is inside the XML structure, so it's next to the XML or in a subfolder of the XML, we will delete that InDesign file. And if it's outside, so it's like somewhere else on your system, we just keep it there. So if you, yeah. I think it's standard behavior, but I just want to mention that. And in regard to EnFocus switch and the relative passes, we are now able to process the switch configurator can now process external Matterprint instances. So you can place your, so you have your switch server where the switch flows work, and the Matterprint can now run on a different machine. So the configurator is not on EnFocus right now, but you can have it from me. There are still some things to do. So currently it only works for InDesign files that came in. If you place an InDesign package into the switch workflow, that does not work yet. But it will work in the future. It's just a switch internal. yeah, it should be by the end of November, I hope. Yeah, I hope. So the if you place an InDesign file, that already works external with a new configurator. Yeah, and for that you need the job ticket license in Matterprint. So if you have switch and Matterprint on the same machine, the auto mode is okay or is sufficient. But if you have an external server, external Matterprint, that must run the job ticket license. So it's, it's the same like the Woodwing or K4 license. It's, but you can then also have better performance because you have multiple instances that can run on different machines and so on. And also for the connection to Matterprint, the old integration is deprecated now, and we have this Woodwing server plugin, which has better customization options for us. So, and also for you, so you can have your own, thing in the Woodwing plugin. And the new thing is we in the Woodwing, we can now directly from the Smart Connection Enterprise panel, you can choose, so you just click on your layout and choose send that layout to Matterprint, and then it will so if you don't, so the general Matterprint Woodwing server plugin works status-based, so each time a document goes into the specific status, the output will be done. And with the new Matterprint, sent to Matterprint, you can just do it anytime you need. Okay. One thing Karina also mentioned in the welcome session is that we have now also just as colors an online support page at help.axaya.com. You can search for topics, and you can also comment, export to PDF, and so on. So we hope everything you want to know is there, and if not, just let us know, and this will be adapted. One more thing. macOS Catalina, we are not supporting macOS Catalina right now. But this support will come when the CC 2020 release is done by Adobe. It should be in early or mid-November. Thank you.